Hey techies, Anthony from HazardNet here, and if my sound is off, it's because I'm recording on a phone, because you'll know why in a second. I'm upgrading my editing computer one more time, so this is going to be the second upgrade. If you watch last year's video, we upgraded the RAM to its max of 64 gigs, and we upgraded to an M2 SSD, which just made it super fast. The final upgrade we're going to do, because we're two generations removed now, or three on the processor. And so the best I think I can do is this, and this is going to be the upgrade. First off, we're going to put this in. This is a Gigabyte Eagle OC 12 gig, although I'm probably, if I can disable the overclocking, I will. But anyway, it is a, as it said, 12 gig. I assume it has the correct ports on it, yeah, Micro Center, of course. And Phil Smith sold all of this to me. So if anything goes wrong, it's his fault. Anyway, so we're going to throw that in, replacing the 1660 Ti that's in there. And the Gigabyte, I believe, has a wattage of 1720. And the 1660 Ti is 120. But when I'm rendering video, it has a habit of kind of hitting that limit. So I had to limit the frame rate in which it was rendering. But obviously for this card, I'm going to need a little bit more power. And then here we go. We have the EVGA 650 GT. It says Supernova, so 650 watt gold. So hopefully this fits in there. The problem with the OEM cases is obviously they're made for cheaper parts. So we're going to try to squeeze all of it in. Now, the one thing you're not going to see is me putting it together. First off, I've never in my life put a power supply into a system. I'm literally going to have to label everything that is currently on the one that's in place and then try to match it up with the new one. And also, well, the graphics card is, take the old one out of the slot, put the new one in, bada bing, bada boom. And since I already use an NVIDIA product, I'm kind of hoping that the graphics card will be the easy part. Just hoping that the power supply has everything I need. The guy assured me, Phil Smith or whatever, assured me at Micro Center in Mayfield Heights, Ohio, that this was all good. It's an hour drive for me, so I don't want to have to go back. And so, I am going to take care of this, and I will come back later, hopefully successful, where I will give up some thoughts. And I will, of course, take some more pictures. So you're probably seeing pictures already of where everything is by default. And hopefully we'll wrap this up. It won't be a long video, because obviously I'm not showing you shot by shot at me doing this. I don't know if you can tell if this camera's shaking or not. It's mounted to the table in which I'm working on, and just a small touch makes everything just shake. Again, limited space for a YouTube studio, so it's not too much I can do with it. But anyway, I'm rambling. Yeah, so we'll be back after I give this a shot and see if it works. So everything installed. Everything worked right away. I didn't make any boo-boos, so I'm good about that. Here is the CPU. It's the normal, whatever, when it settles, it'll be down to about 10%, which is already seems like it's gotten there. Memory, of course, I have 64 gigs of RAM, so it's, you know, already using up like six of it-ish, you know. Disk drive doesn't really matter, blah, 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 blah. This is the onboard graphics card that we're obviously not using, but here is what we did. My 1660 would be chugging at 10% utilization on average. This bad boy, barely 1%. Now, obviously, I'm not rendering video or doing anything special like that, so it's interesting to see this just work out of the box. A little blue LED on the top here. I don't care for LEDs on my system, but either way, 12 gigs of dedicated. It shares up to, looks like 32, and then takes some of the CPU memory. So, I mean, like, it's fantastic. And 42 degrees, so that's pretty good. Celsius, mind you. So far, I'm liking what I'm seeing. And as you see, it is a NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3060. So I went from a 1660 Ti to a 3060. I'm kind of happy the dude talked me up to this this version. I saved $20. Plus, Micro Center had a promotion where I got Midnight Suns, Marvel's Midnight Suns. That new game, I got it for free. So I'm definitely going to go into GeForce and download it at some point. But I wanted to show you that this does, in fact, work. So I'm going to throw some more pictures on here. And you can see the bird's nest
that he ended up with. And yeah, it was really hard to find places for this excess cord, and luckily I was able to get it to kind of wrap around, so I'll be able to stick it kind of like in the case without it obstructing the lid and not blocking any ventilation. So that's just key points here. I'm just really happy with the turnout. It runs really quiet. I don't smell anything burning, so you know, hopefully that's not going to be a problem. And as I mentioned at the beginning, this is pretty much going to be the last upgrade this computer can ever see, because it is 2 to 3 generations removed. And a 3060 probably the best I was going to get in this system. So moving on with that.
So the computer has now been running for about 3 hours. And you can see here the CPU, of course, says it's about 30% utilization, because I'm also running XSplit, which has a habit of using up some CPU power. But as we go through, we can see after 3 hours, I've used a little bit more of the RAM, you know, expected. But then we get to the graphics card, 5% utilization, and that's because I'm running XSplit. Otherwise, it would be nothing. So still 3 hours later, awesome, and it's only gone up 3 degrees. Now, keep in mind, I haven't done any rendering. I've done some basic editing, graphical stuff, text files. So nothing heavy duty. And I feel like this will pull through like a pro. It's quiet. The power supply has a quiet mode, so when it's running low, it will lower its fan speed. And the processor, I can hear it going on and off when it really needs to, so that's really good. And I think this experiment, I, again, for the first time installing a power supply unit myself, I'm just really happy with my own work. As long as no connectors explode or melt, I think I'll be okay. So, I don't know, like, how much more happier do I need to be? Like, oh. With that said, tell me in the comments what you thought about this device. Are you planning to get one? Do you have any questions? Let me know and I will try to answer them. Thanks for watching, and please remember to like and subscribe.